Do you believe, as an artist, just because, just as advice, being somebody who thinks about marketing and branding and things like that, do you think an artist could actually build a sustainable career today, right? Just being a recording artist. I think it's a different era, right? A recording artist back then used to be for real recording artists, and it wasn't that much notoriety you could create about it. But it seems today there's a way where you can get so much of the same visibility but never come out in person,
right?
And make a lot of money.
Definitely. So there is a difference between a recording artist and a performing artist.
Mm-hmm.
There are recording artists that make six figures, and that you and me probably never heard of them. But what they do is they build that fan base online, period. They build the fan base online. They have product. Like, they really have the super fans because they are selling albums.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, they're selling albums. They're selling merch. They have fan clubs. And that's where they're making most of their income. So, but they only do stuff online. They never pull up to anywhere to perform. Now, some of them do live performances where they're broadcasting live online. You know what I mean?
I had a few people where I'm like, I've been trying to get them to do that for years. The ability to just broadcast live, interact with people, do a special performance, do an unplugged live. There's so many things and versions that you can do live that you couldn't do before that. Yeah, there's a lot of cap in that. Then we have all these tipping features on TikTok and all these other platforms.
Exactly.
You can take tips. You can charge people to get in, and they'll still tip you and get some more money out of the process. And sell merch, link in bio or link, hey, go buy it now, have a call to action, all that stuff.
All of that. And that's why I'm saying, like, so for those artists, it's like, for everybody feeling like, yo, I need to get a deal, because you feel like getting a deal is going to get you in places that you might not get in, or whatever the fact, whatever the reason, you know, there's a lot of things that you can do on your own. Like, Summer Walker is dope, hands down. Her pen game is dope. Her voice is dope. She plays multiple instruments. So she literally could have went the recording artist route if you felt like, I'm not a person that likes to be in the public eye. I don't want to be sitting around doing interviews and all that. All
right, but here's another thing, though. The reality of becoming what she's become is hard to cope with or understand before you get there.
So that's another thing. See, everything that glitter ain't gold, right? Your mama used to say, I'm gonna let you touch it just so you can see why you shouldn't be touching it, right? So this is really, for all of us artists looking at it, we've had artist after artist show us why the music industry or getting signed to a label is probably not the best thing. Like, especially now, it's way more artists coming out now that's speaking up about the things that are happening once you sign that contract,
like,
right?
You said YK Osiris said something like that, right?
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah.
So he'd been saying it, and then, like, all these weird stuff started happening in his life. You know, he getting arrested, all this stuff. But he literally was like, bro, like, when you sign that paper, his words, you know, you're basically selling your soul. Now, one thing about independent artists, like, when you sign to a label, you actually become like an employee. Like, you're working like a 9-to-5. You have to bust your ass to get those performances and all this stuff, because the labels, right, the labels are giving you this money that you have to give back at some point. And then it's like, most people don't own their masters. They don't own a lot of stuff. So for a performing artist, you make your money performing or getting sponsors or, you know, having some type of product, linking up with a partnership like Cardi B with Fashion Nova. You know what I mean? It's like, you have to create all these other lanes of income, because a lot of that money that comes back in is going to go to the label and go to the team. It got to be buzzed down like a billion ways. So you have to literally be on call. You got to go to all of these concerts and be in front of all these people, do these. Like, you got to act like you was a 9-to-5. You got to pull up like it's a job.
No, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That's the process. People think artists, I'm creative and I just want to do art for a living. But it's so much more to do it sustainably than just do art for a living.
Right.
Showing up all the time, consistently, maintaining those relationships. You already feel like, oh, you're a two-you person. No, you got to talk to these people. You go to the radio, you go to somebody's podcast or whatever. You still got to make sure not only do they do it and you pay for the service, it's in your best interest to build a relationship with those people again and again. It's an entire process to really nurture. And that's what I mean, though. Like, for one, even outside of all that, just to be recognized by a lot of people when you go outside, that's a completely different experience.
Right.
It's weird. And, like, I know you've probably had, like, environments where people recognize you, right?
You know me a little bit.
But it's different when you think about that, like, What if I'm Justin Timberlake? If I'm Kanye or I'm Jay-Z, Beyonce? And that's a different... And because of what you do, it's a different type of fan, right? Fortunately, because it's a little bit more education. Most of the people are thinking about... Like, people who are looking for education typically aren't the same kind of fools that are just, I'm a fan and I'm a... You know what I mean? Right. That's a different type of person. I'm addicted to you or I'm... A, like, that's a whole nother thing to deal with. And people just want you to either dance for them. I just want a picture or I just want to say I saw you. So I'm going to do something stupid to get your attention. Like, that's a whole nother level of thing. And not to be able to walk outside. That experience is an interesting experience. So I think... People aren't prepared for what that's actually like. It does look good, right?
But so how do you prepare for that, though? That's the question.
Well, that's the thing. You don't find out till you get there if that's you. So then if you start to realize it's not you, you can do what Summer Walker is doing because I think it's pretty early. It's weird now, but I think this is a positive move for her to be doing it this early. It'll hurt in the meantime. It's for people like fans and all that stuff, but now they can strategize on how do we move forward.
But it possibly, because some people just can't. They can say, oh, I'm not doing music anymore. But if you're signed, you have, like, obligations that you have to fulfill.
Some people can't do that.
Right, before you can even get out of a contract. Like, she might have a contract that says you have to put out these many albums. Like, you can say you're not doing music, but if you're not putting out any albums for us, you're not putting out music, period. Like, you can't work with people.
I don't think she says she's not going to do that. Like, LVRN, Love Renaissance, her label, like, I've seen the posts. They've been pretty supportive and understanding of that. Of course, you never know everything that's going on behind scenes, but... They've been supportive of it, and I think they recognize like that the way that team moves. To me, they'll be smart enough to also realize that this is a learning experience because maybe there'll be more artists that we can deal with and create a new model. It'll force you to think about new ways if you want to run business and do business well. Recognize that this isn't just an isolated thing, right? For once you're successful, this gives you an opportunity to learn a new model and create something. How do we maximize on the artist that moves this way? And now as a label. All right, we can take in both types of artists. You want to be out there, do that whole thing, whoop-de-whoop, but we also know how to profit and maximize for the business while also taking care of the artist's health in this type of model as well.
Okay, boom. So you just said something about artists.